And that really stuck with me. He didn't claim religion and didn't claim to be no affiliation with the church. He just wanted to help somebody. And if you ever go through something, you can help somebody else. Reason for some folks can't help nobody. They get spoiled all the life. Amen. But if you've ever been through torment, and if you've ever had a time that you didn't know how to pray, and you didn't know which way to go, amen, you understand the power of God. Praise the Lord. So I thank God for him. Amen. Coming by my way over to that hospital just to let me know that I was going to be all right. And Brother Andy, we ain't perfect, but we're above ground. That means something. Amen. We could have both been dead and in our grave, but God spared us, and I praise him for it. If you would turn to 2 Kings. I thank the Lord for Apostle Shelton being here with me. I never asked him for anything that he did not supply. Some way or another, he made a way for me. And he's just more than a church friend. He's my son. And I'm proud. I'm proud of that. Amen. I know folks, some folks is prejudice or whatever, but if you're prejudiced, you just ain't got enough trouble. If you ever get enough trouble, you don't care who prays for you. Amen. And when I had decided to come to West Virginia, or when I had not decided, Joe decided. And Joe was asking me to look for a building. And I said, I'm not looking for a building. If God wants us to come, he'll make a way. And sure enough, Shelton called me and said, I found a building. And we had great church in there for 2.5 years. Then my health went down and Joe was afraid I was going to die and leave her stuck in West Virginia. And so she took off to North Carolina, and I went with her. But there's something about Christian people. I never get over it. If I ever loved you, I'll love you if I haven't seen you in 20 years. That's the way the love of God works. Amen. Some of us, amen, haven't seen each other in years, but I'm still in love with you. I still care for you. Amen. Want God's best for you. Praise the Lord. If you would turn to 2 Kings. And the 24th verse. Then she saddled an ass and said to her servant, drive and go forward. Slack not thy riding for me, except I bid thee. So she went and came unto a man of God to Mount Carmel.
Yes.
And it came to pass when the man of God saw her afar off, that he said to Gehazi, his servant, behold, yonder is that Shunammite. Run now, I pray thee, to meet her, and say unto her, is it well with thee? Is it well with thy husband? Is it well with thy child? And she answered, it is well. Amen. Father, in Jesus' name, we know with you all things are possible. God, we can believe in you. We can put our confidence in you. Lord, speak to every heart here tonight. My Lord, change every mind here. Help us to grow up in you, Lord. And God, we've slipped away at all. Bring us back to the fold. God, give us what we need to make the city. And I ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. It was in the 1800s. I preached this over the years, and I found out that even today that they are still teaching about the Great Fire of Chicago. And there was a man by Horatio Spafford that owned a considerable amount of property. And his, right before the fire comes, his only son died. Doctors didn't know what killed him. They just know that he died and they buried him. And so he had three daughters. And he told his wife, said, let's go on a ship over to Europe and try to get away to get our minds together. And so his wife complied. And she got them ready to leave to go to Europe. And just before the ship was leaving, some unexpected business came up. And so Mr. Spafford told his wife, said, you and the girls go ahead and I'll catch the next ship so I can take care of this business. And so it was wired back that the ship had sank. And they was in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean. And another big ship hit their ship and it went down. So Mr. Spafford was waiting to hear from his wife or his children to see if he had anybody left. And he got a notice from his wife, and all it said was left alone. He knew that by her saying that her his daughters had perished. So he got a ship and he told the captain of the ship, said, I want you to show me the place that my children went down. I want to know where they perished. Well, according to history, the captain was afraid to show him, afraid that he would jump in the water to be with his daughters. And he kept insisting, show me the place where my daughters perished. And so finally, in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean, the captain come up beside him and said, right here is where your daughters went down. And the story says that the captain was fixing to grab him in case he tried to jump. But when he got to that place, he poured out a piece of paper and a pen, and he wrote this down: when peace like a river attendeth my way, and sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever the cost, thou hast taught me to say, it is well, it is well with my soul. That's where that song came from. And you wonder how a man can have such faith, losing so much, all four of his children, but he was still willing to trust God. If you ever get to the place that you know that your help comes from God,
yes,
and amen, regardless of what happens, regardless of what comes or goes, Amen. You trust God.
Amen.
I was raising Marilyn's baby girl. And she was crippled. I had to carry her to church. I had to pack her. And just about broke my back trying to help that girl. And one day she went in the hospital and a doctor gave her a shot and killed her. And I had to trust God. God, you know what was best for her and you know what was best for me. Regardless of what you go through, you've got to learn to trust God. Even when you can't trace him.
Amen.
Amen. If there were some honest people in here tonight, you would say many is a time that you didn't know how to pray.
Yeah, come on.
You didn't know what to tell the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen. All you did is, God, I've got a problem that I can't solve. I got a problem that I don't have an answer for. But I'm trusting you.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. That you are God.
Yes.
And that you are doing what's best for me.
Yes.
Some of y'all right now are going through changes. And some of your changes you don't even like. But God knows the road that you take. And when he has tried you, you shall come forth as pure gold. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. You never understand God. The truth of the matter. Amen. You got to trust God. And it seems like crazy. He'll talk to you about building the church when you don't have this one for. Amen. He'll let you go through things that you think are insurmountable. And you don't know how you're going to get out of it. Amen. But you got to learn to trust God. Hallelujah. Amen. Elisha was a prophet. And he came to the land. Amen. Of the Shunem. And there was a Shunammite woman. And the Bible said she was a great woman. I come here to tell you tonight, the only thing that makes you great is your confidence in your God. Hallelujah. Praise his name. Amen. A couple years ago, I was working on a house on the west side. They called me and said that Shelton had gone out. Amen. They thought he had died. I jumped in my car and ran to the hospital. And Sister Helen, I was crying out to God all the way to the hospital. And the time I got there, Brother Shelton was talking. And God raised him back up. Because my God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that you may think or ask. This Shunammite woman, the Bible said she was a great woman, not because she had riches, not because she was the prettiest woman, but because she believed in her God, and she recognized the prophet. Some of y'all have problems because you don't recognize the prophet in your midst. And if the prophet would tell you something, you fail to believe God's word. word. Hallelujah. It may be somebody right here in this group that has a word from God that will deliver your life and make ways for you. Hallelujah. This woman saw the prophet coming by her house, and she asked her husband, let us build a room and put a table in the room and put a chair there and put him a candle there, because he was a prophet and he had to write stuff down. Hallelujah. Amen. But what I found out about God, you'll never outgive him. He'll always give you more than you've ever given him. When you fall by the wayside, he's always there to pick you up. When you get cold on God, he's always there to say, I still love you. Somebody praise God in here. Hallelujah. Amen. The prophet said, go ask the woman what she has need of. Hallelujah. So Gehazi, amen, the servant, went to the Shulamite woman, and the word Shulam means a place of rest. While you're running this race, amen, this Christian walk, every now and then you need a place to rest. But I heard Jesus say, come unto me, all you that are labored and heavy burden, and I will give you rest. Somebody give me praise. I'm feeling the Holy Ghost. Bless his name. Gehazi went to the woman and said, what do you have need of? She said, I'm an old woman and I have no son to leave my husband. It's hard to preach that now because people are killing babies every day. But in that day, if God give you a son, you were blessed of the Most High God. Amen. If you people here have sons and daughters, you ought to praise God that God smiled down upon you and blessed your house. Somebody put your hands together and bless his name. Hallelujah. Amen. He went back and told Elisha, said she's of old age and she don't have a baby. Amen. He went to the woman, said, this time next year, you're going to have a son. She was afraid to believe him. She said, don't tell me this if it's not so. And he said, it is so. If God ever gives you a word, you hang on to that. He's God that ain't come out lie. He's the Son of Man that he will not repent. If he said it, he'll make it good. Give God some glory in here. Hallelujah. So when he passed by, he would always stay in that room. Amen. And a child grew Amen. Become strong. Now in that day, when you was 12 years old, you went to work. Can't hardly get people to go to work at 30 now. But amen, he was 12 years old. And he went out to the field with his father. And there he began to collect all the crops that his father had sown. Hallelujah. But one day, he was out there with his daddy, and he screamed out, "My head, my head." Devil preach right there. We got a lot of sick heads in the church. Hallelujah. Praise his name. He told his servant, said, "Take the boy back to his mother. Because there's no love like a mother's love." Amen. Amen. I don't care how strong you are. When you're really down and out, you want to talk to your mama. Hallelujah. She went up to the prophet's room. And she laid the child down the bed and laid his head down, amen, in her lap. And she started praying. I'm telling you, God listens all the day. I'm going to stop being preaching good. Because y'all ain't praising God. To hear his children pray. Hallelujah. But the child wouldn't wake up. So she went out to the field and told her husband, said, "Give me a servant and give me an ass that I may go yonder to the prophet." He said, "It's not a new moon. It's not time for sacrifice. Why are you going? Is everything all right?" She said, "It is well. It is well. I don't care how far down you feel. I don't care how discouraged you feel. You can cry out to the Lord and say, it is well. It is well with my soul. I cut my shanda hoya. Praise God. Nowhere in the text does it tell that she knew where the prophet was. But she believed if she went, she could find the prophet. I'm telling y'all, Beverly is the overseer of this work. But even Beverly needs a prophet now and then to speak in her life. Amen. To give her instruction. Hallelujah. She went one with the ass. And she told the young man, "Don't slow down unless I tell you." In other words, I'm desperate. I'm desperate. I've got to get to the man of God. My Lord, Sister Helen, the apostles and the prophets have got to come back to the church in order for the church to get her miracles. Somebody say yeah. prophet seen her coming from afar off. I'm so glad when people don't see me, God sees me. When people don't understand me, God understands. I go to church and don't seem like no love there. But when I get to Jesus, he makes everything all right. Hallelujah. I'm so glad that God sees me. He understands me. You may not understand me. You may not believe in me. But God looks afar off. And he sees me. And he didn't bring me this far to leave me. I'm not brought out to the desert to die. Amen. In the desert place is my blessing. What they thought would kill me was a thing that blessed me. Somebody praise God because you're blessed. Commanded by God,
yes,
to love every one of y'all.
That's right.
Every one of you, whether I know your name or don't. I am commanded to love you.
Amen.
To pray for you.
Amen.
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 But if you don't love me back, it ain't going to stop me.
Amen.
Amen. I would love for us to be friends and be nice to one another. But if you got some kind of spirit that you don't care for me, God bless you. I got over you. Hallelujah. Long as I got King Jesus. It's gonna be alright. Say yeah. Say yeah. You gotta pray. God damn you praise him. God damn you praise him. When praises go up, your blessings coming down. Give your God a pray. Gehazi said, take my staff and give her the staff.
Yes.
And tell her to lay it on the baby. And she left there happy.
All right.
She left there believing,
oh, yes,
that God had answered. But when she got back to the house, she laid the staff on the baby, the child, and it didn't wake up. It was still dead. Have you ever been to a place that you cried out to God and you cry and you cry and you cry,
yeah,
and nothing don't happen?
Yeah.
God is teaching you. I said, God is, yeah, teaching you. Amen. To trust him when you can't even trace him. So she didn't quit there. She got that servant and got that ass and she run back to the prophet. He asked her, is all well? She said, all is well. She said, but I put the staff on the child and it didn't wake up. So the prophet said, oh, I'm going down there and see what scripture. He laid his hands on her on that countenance. He laid his face on that boy's face. She laid his leg on that boy's leg. And said, arise. We're getting up. You're getting up out of here. That woman didn't lose her faith. And her boy come back to life. I don't know who I come to preach to. But I come to tell somebody, don't lose your faith. God may not come when you want him. But he's on time. He's an on time God. He may not answer like you think. But put your trust in a God that cannot fail. Somebody give me praise. Somebody give me praise. It is so. It is so. God for. I don't know what it is. My son is in jail. Don't know how long he's going to serve. They ain't had no court date. But I believe God for a miracle. I believe God. I know God could get him out tomorrow. But I still believe God. I still believe God. Some of y'all right here got children that are not serving God. Hallelujah. But hold your faith. Hold your faith in a God that cannot fail. Praise his name. Hallelujah. Brother Andy had open heart surgery and he come to tell me I was going to be alright. And you will never know, Andy, what that meant to me, that you cared enough to encourage me. And I think he had one bypass, is that right? Two bypasses. I had four. Amen. And when I went in that operating room, Joe and Tammy was trying to tell me, honey, you'll be all right. I told Joe, I said, Joe, I got peace about it. I ain't afraid. If the sun don't come up in the morning, I know I'm safe. I know I'm safe. If I don't make it through this, look for me in glory. Because I'll be there. Hallelujah. Whatever your problem is, whatever your burden is, take it to the Lord and leave it there. Take it to the Lord. How wonderful you people coming out here to be in this revival. And you may think, well, I'll get blessed tonight, but this revival, amen, may be a blessing to some of you 3 months down the road. 6 months down the road. Because when you heard the word and you put it down in your heart Amen. God will answer. And he'll come on the scene. I never got to see some of my grandchildren growing up. Hardly at all. Friday night, last Friday, this grandson right here was the first time he ever heard me preach. Amen. He's 14 years old. Amen. And I don't think he even noticed, but every day of his life, I pray for God to save him. And give him the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Praise God. Amen. He was raised from pillar to post.
Yeah.
Never know where he's going to be next. But God made a way.
Yeah.
Tammy lives down in Holden Beach. Right close to Myrtle Beach. And she took these three boys, and when Beverly asked me for this revival, Tammy said, "Dad, I'm going to try to come to that revival." I didn't know it. I didn't know she was going to bring no grandchild. She hadn't told me about it, but God put it on her. I said, "God put it on her to bring my grandson to this church." And Friday night he got the Holy Ghost. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Amen. It didn't look like it was going to happen. I wondered how God was going to do it. But all the time, God was working on my prayer, answering my prayers, and I got all together 10 grandchildren, and I believe in God that they all get the Holy Ghost, that they all serve God. If you don't know Jesus tonight, you can come to the altar. If you can't, kneel down, sit on the altar. And give God your life. Give God your heart. Hallelujah. I don't know how I would have made it this far had it not been for the Lord that was on my side. Is there anybody tonight want to pray? Anybody want to come to the altar? Oh, God is here. God is here.
Come on, devil.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on to the altar. Why God is calling you. Why the blood still running warm in your veins. Amen. Tomorrow's not promised you. Amen. You may not wake up in the morning. You need to give your heart to the Lord. Amen. Come on. Jesus to praise the Lord. You that have the Holy Ghost, come up and pray for these.
Hallelujah. We just thank you, Lord. We praise you, God. As those that's making their way down the aisle now, God, to receive from you, Lord. Oh, God, we just cast all our care, Lord, upon you, God, for you care for us, Lord, when we couldn't even care for ourselves, Lord.